That yellow Lambo outside, but when I trapped in the sun, that green Ferrari sitting outside when I couldn't make bun. I gave the plug to my nigga, I gave the game to my sons.
Alright, this is Wholesome Podcast, Wholesome B Mitch, Wavy Trey in the building there today. So like, for y'all that don't know, so like, Trey's my cousin, and then we got our other cousin with us.
Yeah, he the youngest one out of the clip.
Marcus.
I don't know about that shit, but he the oldest. I'm the second oldest, and he younger.
Yeah, so we got the young buck in the building.
Yeah.
What up, people?
To get his views and shit.
Yeah, so what I want to know is, so like, I seen this thing circulating. You know, Future, he always in his Toxic Bags album came out
Shout
recently.
Out Future.
He was tweeting, though, and he said something like, I gotta leave them ugly girls alone or something like that. What he said?
So leave them ugly girls alone.
That's exactly what he said.
That's literally what he said.
The Future is the head coach. He's the head coach. He's the GM.
Shout out to coach.
You know what I'm saying? We just follow his playbook.
So what I wanna know though is, was fucking with ugly girls like a thing? Like, so clearly it was a thing for even a nigga like Future. So I mean, what's y'all experience with ugly girls?
You got any?
I mean, and you down and out, sometimes you gotta do some shit, but it's all about elevation. So that way he said, leave them alone, because he went through that period of time.
Everybody has a
problem. The older you get, racial standards.
So, what's your experience with the ugly Jones?
I mean, I've definitely had a couple of ugly Jones in my day, but you know what I mean? Everybody has to be loved at some point in time. You know, you share your love with who you need to share your love with. And, you know, hopefully they prosper from that.
So, I mean, okay, well, that's actually a good point of view. So, if that's the case, then why are you leaving them alone? Are you keeping it going with them?
No, I'm leaving them alone because I got to keep my prospering for myself at this point. You
know but what I mean? So I'll say for me, it's like, I already had decided a couple months ago I was done with them. Like,
so, what changed in these couple months?
Like you said, just getting older, like, you know, I'm 30 now.
Like, right. You got to have standards. I got to be better for myself.
Yeah, so I decided, like, a few months ago, like, I can't do this. I can't do this no more.
That's super what's up.
That's what I got in my life and shit. I'm like, why? Like, all this shit is not that serious.
Y'all leaving one important thing out, though, and I'm going to just keep it a buck. The ugly ones give the best neck. If we just being real. The fat ones, the bigger ones, excuse me, and the ugly ones.
So you like big women, ugly women?
I don't necessarily like them, but I don't discriminate.
It's nothing wrong with liking. First of all, what determines somebody is even ugly? What determines that? Like, let's actually get...
That's great.
Because, for me...
Personality is ugly.
Yeah, I was going to say, it's not just a look.
Yeah.
Oh, your personality can be ugly, absolutely.
That's the most important thing. Your personality comes first.
Yeah, but you're not necessarily... When you're young, you're not worried about a personality, necessarily. Unless her personality throws you off completely.
Right. I was going to say, let's say today, though. Like, today. I mean, because you 25?
Yeah, 26.
Right? 26, yeah.
Oh,
yeah,
man.
You're gradually old now, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
So, at all of us above 25...
Yes.
What determines if a chick fits that ugly category to where we can't deal with it? Like, I'm not finna go that route with
them. So you let me know first.
I mean, for me, I just said personality is gonna factor in.
We know if that, you, though. Looks, though. Looks, strictly looks.
It's not just strictly looks for me, because if you have the confidence and you got the swag where you carry yourself in a high manner, I'm gonna still give you some time of day. If you carry yourself high standards, you walk around like that, then, I mean, the look is not that relevant for me.
That's what's up. That's what's up. Here's the thing, though. I mean, I'm going to be honest. If your teeth are jacked, I might not look your way. I'm going to just be a buck. Not like my teeth are perfect, you know what I'm saying? But your teeth can't be just like...
So the grill got to be right.
Important.
What else? I mean...
And how you present yourself. If you present yourself outside of like...
Representation of Van Park.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? Like how, like dressing and stuff like that. You know what I'm saying?
So you can't dress whack.
You can't dress whack.
So
like,
wait.
Pay attention at your dressing. Just like women do. I'm looking at your shoes.
So dressing fashionable or dressing well?
Dressing appropriate.
Like there's differences.
Dressing not necessarily appropriate, but dressing appropriate for where you're at. If you pull up to some shit and you got... some sweats on and you look bogus and some sandals, I'm gonna flame you. You know,
some of the fitted sweats.
No. I understand that. I'm not talking about the cute fitted sweats. You know what I'm saying? Where you're going outside, you're trying to really meet somebody. I'm talking about the sweats where you just hopped outside. You just got out the shower. You finna run outside, take the trash out, go back inside.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? But you had to run up the street to the gas station.
And
me being me, I'm trying to pull up on you. Okay. Because I know you, you know what I'm saying? I see your
face. So she got look good going to the gas station?
Nah. That's kind of what you're saying.
That's kind of what I'm saying, yeah.
So I will come back to that. But I want to hear Trey didn't mention what his ugly is. But I'm definitely got something to say to come back to that. We're going to come back to that.
Oh, you want to hear my ugly?
Because we ain't here with yours. So his, you got to have teeth. Your teeth got to be put together. You got to walk outside.
Please have teeth.
Please have teeth.
Yeah, like, nigga,
that,
what?
Have them.
Yeah, I mean, yeah.
That's important. We're going to have 32 teeth. How many teeth are you supposed to have? How many?
A lot. Might be 32, 34, 36. I don't know.
You better have all them adult teeth, though, huh?
We grown.
What if she got baby teeth? Like, you know, people got them little teeth.
She ain't had braces yet. She probably got to get her teeth.
Right.
And again, no disrespect to these women. Y'all are beautiful in your own right. But, you know, it just ain't for certain people. You know what I mean?
So, Trey, what's the ugly category for you? What's the ugly category for you?
Ugly, you know, the most attractive, but personality is great and shit. But people who shame women who are bigger, I don't mind women bigger than me and shit. That's okay. What the fuck that got to do with anything else? You're big and you're beautiful. Okay, cool. Type shit.
So what's the ugly bag, though,
ugly
for you?
Personality.
Oh, just personality? Just strictly personality?
And then you got ugly personality, and then you like a 5 out of 10.
Y'all really care about who she is, huh?
I mean, as far as she is
the point.
Absolutely. But I'm talking about...
if it's a one-night stand, like...
That's what I'm thinking.
Yeah,
I don't necessarily think about who she is.
No, one-night stand, like, clearly something attracted me. Like, we conversing at one point. Oh, shit, you dope. Oh, you was funny. Type shit.
Yeah, even on a one-night stand joint, if you're whack as a person... I won't put you out because I've grown past that. But in my days, I would put you out. Like, you whack. I'm not finna do this.
Yeah.
Afterwards or before?
Well, it depends on my
life. Yeah, you see, that's what I'm talking about. I'm talking about afterwards. It's like, okay, yeah.
And she look good, nigga gonna try to hit. But
yeah, that's all I'm saying.
Even as an old man and shit, I'm talking to you. I still want to fuck you tonight. Everyone see it every day. Cool. But... this first thing that's gonna catch me is like, can we convert? Can we talk and shit? What are we talking about right now?
Now that's after. Let's say, like, for example, if a one night stand carries
one out time,
but you might catch a one night stand that may turn into something more if her conversation or who she is is something that you find valuable or worth. You know, worth keeping around.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
Right.
Everybody's been in that situation.
But if I catch her at a one night stand, she's just gonna stay at a certain level.
I mean, but for me, I might not even want to hit that first night if I don't have some type of attraction beyond physical with you. It's been stretched why I have not hit just because, like, you just... I'm not going to do it. It's been some bad joints.
Absolutely.
It's been some bad joints where I literally passed up on it because I was like, nah.
And that what I'm talking about, like, beforehand, like,
I don't think Trey passing it up. Trey talking that shit. Trey ain't passing it up.
How you going to tell me what
Trey's
I would do?
Not passing it up.
I'm sitting between y'all. I'm like, y'all, I'm not passing
you,
it up.
You
know? I'm trying to learn how you're passing it up. But that's wisdom that comes with time.
I'm,
you
know, passing, I mean, some stuff up.
Then they don't know me.
Trey ain't passing shit up.
Matt, if she's on the borderline, I'm probably going to pass her up.
It does depend if I'm drunk, though.
It's a one-nighter joint. Everybody probably been drinking.
Probably lit.
So
you're drunk, so you're willing to go.
It's some shit, yeah.
But if I wasn't drunk, I'm like, no, I need more than it. But drunk me, don't give a fuck.
Yeah, but you be lit. But I'm not saying I'll be passing them a lot, but I'm just saying I have.
Yeah.
I'll be shooting from
the I think everybody passed a couple times in life. Have you? Like, every time a bitch is wildish, she might be just she not the person for you. Like, it's not even worth it.
Trey, you not passing it up. We both know situations like this.
What would she have to be like for you to pass her up? I guess is the question. That's kind of
like nigga wildish. I don't pass her a couple times.
That's what it'll come down to. It's like, what's up?
Wait, what you gotta say? Get on me, chat, nigga.
No,
it's a podcast. I'm an open book.
Here's an example.
Let's set up a scenario, a hypothetical. Random scenario I'm just gonna create in my head. Let's just say you're at a bar, you meet a young lady, seems like, you know, regular individual, seems like a nice young lady, well put together. Mm. I mean, y'all chilling, y'all drinking. As drinks get to flowing, She starts getting a little bit more physical, getting a little handsy, but in a very aggressive manner, you know? She's very aggressive with it.
Oh, she's being disrespectful.
Not necessarily.
Not disrespectful in a bad way. Me and my, you know, disrespectful is a good thing where I come from.
Right, yeah. So
disrespectful
she's,
in a good thing.
Yeah,
a good way.
So she's mad
she's
handsy.
Kind of rude.
You know? She's real handsy with it. So as the night continues, you guys are vibing. You like the chick. She's fine. Fine in the mug. But as you start to leave the bar, you know, she's like, yeah, I'm going to come through. I'm going to slide with you or whatever. So you leave the bar. And like I said, she's very aggressive. She just, say she just, maybe before you get to the car, she just punches you.
You said, wait.
Say she just punches you. Okay. So she just punches you just randomly. You know, sometimes that's pretty playful. You know, girls like play fighting sometimes.
She punches, yeah, would you say that punches you in the arm or something?
Let's say she punches you in the back of the head.
Yes, I would abort mission, but I'm curious to see how you would handle this hypothetical.
Let's say it seemed playfully, so you turn around and say, "What the fuck? What are you doing?" What about when you when you turn around? What if she squares up and say, "Nigga, what's up?"
Oh, yeah, that's the type of time we all, yeah.
But wait. This is completely hypothetical. Let's say you turn around, she squares up. You're like, well, what are you doing? Like, let's just get in the car. Let's come on. And she's like, nah, let's go. And she just, boom, give you one, two. Bye-bye. And she, you know, she her shoulders get to bouncing. She got her feet bouncing. And you still stuck like, what the hell are you doing?
She's looking real Layla right now.
So then
in her Layla bag.
So then you like, look, I'm not going to play with you. You go to the car. She follows behind. It's time to get in the car. So you hop in. You have a seat. She's waiting outside the car. She's like, bitch, nigga, get out the car. Get out the car, nigga. You're like, what the fuck is wrong with you?
She's no longer. She's still trying to come to the crib in the hypothetical.
She still wants to come to the crib. So you're like, what the hell? So she doesn't get out the car. So you get out the car and you're like, what's going on? And she hits you with a three-piece. Boom. Jab, jab, uppercut.
She's tough.
And at this point, you grab her, you throw her in the car. Looks like kidnapping. Cars riding by. They're looking like, what the hell is he? Is he kidnapping this girl? Because you got to, like, him or up, throw in the car. So then she's in the car. She's like, all right, I'm cool. I just had to see what your hands was like. I just had to see if you had hands in case something pop off.
Jiggy fuck.
So then, yeah, let's say she starts gangbang. So then you ride into the crib. You threw her in the back seat because You didn't want no smoke up front, so you threw her in the back. Like, you got to sit in the back, Trey. Put your seatbelt on. And all of a sudden, she starts telling you about her set, you know, about her game. She's like, well, you know, where are you from? And you're like, well, shit, I'm from, since we're talking about Trey, he's like, well, I'm from
in this
Florida. Yeah, that's how they're talking about Trey. He's like, yeah, and I'm from Florida. And she's like, well, shit, I'm from the sixth. We're gonna just make up some. I'm from Rolling Creek.
Gary.
I'm from, and then so this is a completely hypothetical situation. This has never happened. And so
this is great.
You finally get home. You finally get to your crib. You're like, well, what the fuck, this bitch? So she's a gamer. She's just beating me up. As you're walking into your crib, you know she's happy. She's like excited to go to your crib. You know you're like, man, this bitch fine. Then she starts explaining how she's been to jail, and how she just got out, how she's only been out a few days, and she just got done serving a bid.
This is at the house.
Yeah, so this is as you're walking into your crib. She just got done with a bid. You know, she just got out. You know, she's been waiting to get some dick. You know what I'm saying? So she's ready for this. Soon as y'all walk through the door, boom, she punched, pow, still on you, punch you. Now you like, okay. It wasn't a soft one. You felt this one. You felt this punch.
She's coming with the heat at this point.
You felt this one. So she punched you, boom, rush you, throw you into the wall. You're like, okay, let me stop playing with this bit. So you got to like, look, chill. You got to chill. So now now she's smiling. She likes that stuff. That's what she wanted. She wanted that. She wanted you to get extra aggressive. Ooh, chill. She's like, ooh.
Do you aggressively throw her out the house?
So how would you... No, so yeah. So what's the next step? So now she's turned on. She's dripping. She's flying in the mug. She's dripping. You see it on her face. You just like, damn, she like that. Now what? How do you continue going forward? You're in the crib. She just punched you super hard. You felt it. Took the air to your chest. You had to get... You gasped. Okay. one of them. He snatched her up and she said, ooh.
You gotta ask her what her barriers are.
Like, so she, what out of 10, how good does she look?
Let's say she an 8. 8 out of 10. Yeah. Body banging.
How did I meet her?
At the bar.
Yeah, no, this is the hypothetical.
Okay.
Let's say we use at the bar.
This is one of them one night stands.
This is one night stand. So when you this is how you was introduced to her. You was introduced because your dad knew her mom from way back in the day. So your parents knew each other from way back in the day. This is how you was introduced.
Oh, for real?
So the families know each other, and the families don't know she's crazy, but the families know each other. You got her back in the crib. Now you're at the crib. She stole you, lost the air in your chest. You snatched her up. Now what?
If I met her through my father, my dad got good judgment of character. Even though she might have beat my ass, clearly, in the reasoning, clearly she might got some good. She might just be a good person, personality and shit. I'm gonna take my chances.
So you're gonna take your chances on that, Marcus? What are you doing? She just beat your ass. She beat your ass, game banged on you, told you just got done doing a bit.
I'm gonna take my chance.
Here's the thing, I'm gonna keep it.
She probably got some fire. I'm gonna
keep it 1G with you.
It might be good.
Because now she knows where I live.
She stole
it's,
on
it's
you.
A, I mean, if she stole on me.
I mean, if she was in jail, she ain't drunk in a while, so the liquor might got it too.
Yeah, like she might really be so, lit, but she's obviously loving what I'm doing. You know what I'm saying? Here's where the tough part comes in. I'm gonna hit, right?
Okay, yeah.
I'm gonna hit.
Yeah.
But after I hit, it's now like, okay, how do I go about this?
How do you get her out your crib?
What, she just leave on her own? She
you're lit. Uber. I mean, no, you probably gonna have to spend the night.
So let me,
but you're mulling
she,
on that
she
thing.
She might spend the night.
She's spending the night. You're lit. She's lit. She's not going nowhere. She's now, at this point, you've hit her. She's in love with you.
So let me.
I'm not in love with you, but she's. This nigga just hemmed me up.
Right.
He just hemmed me up.
So y'all both say I hit. So, okay, then y'all go to the room. What if as soon as y'all go to the room, she gets back at it again?
Before I hit?
Bah, 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 bah.
Prior to hitting.
We already in the bedroom.
No. Y'all in the bedroom. You take your shirt off. Get your shirt off your head.
I'm getting stalled. I can't even get in my bag. I can't have you around when I'm trying
what
to.
If that's just
every dude, you know.
I'm going to take my chance.
How do you get in your little, like,
I don't know.
Your
niggas
persuasion?
Niggas figure it out.
So
you what? That's
she looks good.
So well, some people like rough stuff.
Do you like rough stuff? This is the hypothetical. Do you like rough stuff?
In certain scenarios, I'm not against it.
How rough is too rough? How about that? Let's talk about limits. How rough is too? So
what?
For me, she would have been cut short. Wait, I was going to say, hold on, wait.
Yo,
you can't even get. No, we're not doing this. Like,
streets got to pay her tax.
You got it. You can't even come to the crib.
I might hit you up again.
So what? How rough is too rough?
That is
y'all?
Very rough.
How rough? What's y'all limits? When are y'all saying pineapples like Kevin Hart said? When is it y'all limit? When are y'all saying no? Stop.
If she's trying to get in her slapping bag, we're done.
Slapping?
Yeah, you're not gonna slap me.
And she might
just
be
punching.
And she might be intoxicated.
No, punching is too far.
And she might have been intoxicated. Then not her true self. And that bit might be good. So I'm gonna take a chance.
So at what limit are you gonna say, okay, this is too far?
Have you never heard drunk, what is it, sober thoughts or
drunk?
I don't know, it's hypothetical, but shit.
It's a hypothetical.
She might have been tarred.
But what's your limit though?
I don't know, I'll take
choking you, stabbing you. What can they do in the bedroom
she
for you to say, stop?
She clearly has the upper hand.
Don't stab me, but the little. Like, don't stab me. But the little whole scenario he talked about. I might be with the shit.
What's your limit?
That ain't my limit.
What is?
Don't stab me.
So, if you don't draw blood, you're good.
Don't stab me. Oh, no. Like, you didn't create me for a reason. Don't stab me.
Don't draw no blood.
She could pistol whip you, slap you with all type of stuff.
She pulled the heater out the backpack.
But as long as she don't stab you.
I don't know, I mean.
And she needs you to hear what she's saying.
Especially was stabbing drawing blood.
So you could possibly have blood drawn.
Don't draw my blood.
Well, I mean, you know, she punching and shit. She might actually hit your lip. You know what I'm saying? Hit your nose.
She has been punching.
I don't hit females. I'm not getting rough shit, but it's going to be too rough.
So you're cool with it being extra rough, you know?
if it's between like is 5 and 10 minutes.
You like that play
fight. If they pass 10 minutes, it might be too long. I might be tired. I want to go to sleep.
So, okay. So you're into that. So she pull out, you know, whips, all that shit. Yep.
Don't whip me either.
You're just with that.
Don't whip me.
I mean, to each other, there's nothing wrong with it.
Yeah. Maybe I would be. Don't hit me with shit.
As long as you don't
get that. She can just punch you. She just can't hit you with anything.
If you punch me, man, shit.
Okay, fair enough.
I mean,
she can punch you. She just can't hit you with anything.
She can hit this nigga with shit. That's clear. He said he don't want to get stabbed. He's trying to renege on the stab. It's cool. You want to get with the bottle. That's cool.
No, so,
she slide, hit you upside down.
Ain't nothing wrong with it.
You'll be good.
If it don't hurt too much, I can deal with the shit. I'm with the shit. Don't fuck up my skin.
That was just a hypothetical situation.
Yeah, very hypothetical.
The reason why I brought it up, so you were saying that. You would turn some stuff down, but clearly that's what led us to that. Because you would say
she'd have to pull the knife out of her back pocket for you to be like, all right.
This is, and I'm saying, well, would you really?
If she look good and accidentally beat me up, I'm with the shit.
It accidentally.
So that's not going to stop you.
Accidentally beats you up.
But you say
she got like 3 minutes into it and was like,
oh no, man, it's shit that I'm turning down. Like, I'm okay with turning some shit down
at that moment in time.
What you need before?
How about another hypothetical? Y'all, so, we gonna keep real. So, all of us have had sex with white women before, right?
Yes.
Yeah.
Y'all finish, y'all know where I'm going with this. What if she calls, so what if y'all got her in the room already, she naked, and she say, give me that dick, nigga. Who's still going? Who's gonna go still? She's naked.
That's awkward. I'm probably not gonna hit her.
You're lying.
No, you have to let me break it down. I haven't finished. You get me out of here. I'm going to let her. She's going to suck my dick. That's just it.
I'm putting that bitch out. Out of my house.
That's real.
I'm putting her out. Like, literally. Like, oh, that's cool. You naked. But here you go. Here you go, your clothes. No, you can. Yeah, you go ahead and leave. It's cool. Don't worry about it. That's cool. I don't do that.
You're not even gonna be mad. That's real.
I don't do that. I don't do that. You don't do that. I don't do that. Nah, we ain't doing that.
That's respect.
Trey, what you gonna do?
I would do the same.
Yeah, nah.
Oh! I would do the same.
Crazy. Oh, man.
What's our answer? If I'm drunk, I don't remember, do that count?
This thing I was gonna say, well, first of all, everybody know you as turned up Trey. You be drunk all the time.
Oh, do man. I?
So, nigga said, I'm drunk.
Oh, no. If it slip up, I don't hear it. All right. But if I'm just cognizant, you know what's going on.
Yo, if you slip up, and I don't hear it.
Like, no, that would not happen.
She clearly says it like, no.
Like, give me that dick, nigga.
I don't think that would happen.
And she says it like she's been saying it to her friends. Like, she used to saying it. Give me that dick.
It stopped.
So either way. So you with it though?
I'm not with it.
As long as you didn't, if you heard her, you're not with it. If you didn't hear,
then how would I know?
This is just a hypothetical.
How good is your hearing?
I got good hearing, but hypothetically, okay. If I heard it and was aware that she said it, then I would not go through with it.
Drunk, you've been out all night. You've been
this
searching.
Be lit.
If she said it, I didn't hear it, then that's a different story.
I'm talking about, this is one, like, as far as the hypothetical, I don't know. You know you had them ones where you in the club, like, okay, fuck it, I'm low-key about to invest in this one for this time being. You know what I'm saying? I'm about to sit and really cook it up because she's gone. You know what I'm saying? She's going to let me cook. You get back to the crib and she pull that, you really just going to go to bed? Because you could let her, like me, I'm going to let her nod me, and I'm be like, okay,
if I'm cognizant,
I might not even say that. I'm just put my shorts on.
If I'm cognizant of the situation, know she's saying the N word, I would not go through with it.
Mm-hmm. Y'all
are so real. Cognizancy might.
So be what would you do? How would you react?
Who's that? Me and a friend, or just me?
It's you and her. Y'all in the room. She's naked, laying on your bed,
going, waiting on you.
Said, "Come here, give me that dick."
If I'm aware of her saying this. I'm like, you're
looking
the woman,
her eye to eye, saying
you're not the woman for me. Please don't say this word.
Please don't. Look, I'm saying, look, you need to get the hell out.
Please
don't say I ain't saying it off black like that. Yes, I'm snapping on her.
You're going to be
without raising my voice.
I'm raising my voice, but like, We're living in a crucial era. If a white woman says some crazy shit, nigga done did it. So I'm going to say in a very nice tone voice, you're not a woman for me. Please get out.
That's so dope.
And what is she like? I heard it in a song.
I'm not a rapper.
I mean, they love saying that, but
I'm not a rapper.
Tell me what y'all think about these song lyrics. If she get attached, then I'm going on the run. Well, first of all, I even get into that. So, like, are y'all currently searching? Y'all in a relationship? Y'all in a relationship? Y'all search for a relationship?
I'm telling Trey, I need a girlfriend.
He literally told me that right before we recorded. Thing, he wants a girlfriend.
I want a girlfriend, but I also feel I'm too old for a girlfriend. So
okay, that's a little different.
Yeah.
So what do you think about the song lyrics? If she get attached, then I'm going on the run. Future voice.
Does that mean like she attached? I'm not ready for it. Like I'm gonna back off. Like I'm not ready for her to be attached. I want her to be attached.
I think that's what that means.
If I don't want you being attached to me, then don't be attached to me.
Well, what if she does get attached though? Then what do you do?
He's saying that she's getting attached and now I'm
ready. Now he's out.
How do you feel about that?
Yeah, how react.
I'm not gonna leave you alone until you leave me alone. But I'm like, I'm gonna let you know, like, if I don't want you to be attached, I'm going to let you know. So we can be cool and don't invest your feelings too heavily.
But once your feelings are invested, you're just going to continue on like it's all good.
Yeah. Yeah. I'm letting know, like, how my viewpoint. Mm-hmm. But I'm good. If you're good, I'm good.
Right. So if she get attached and I'm going on the run, Marcus, react.
I'm going to keep it a beam. If she's getting attached, I'm going to let her know, yo, sweetheart, this isn't. You don't want to get attached over here. Just keep it a beam.
Why does she don't want to be attached?
It's not it because I'm as the lyric goes, I'm on the run. This is not me, right? This is the lyric.
Yeah.
So
your interpretation.
You don't want to. Yeah, my interpretation is you don't want to get attached because I'm on the run.
Now, well, if they get attached, then you're going on the run. You're not on the run yet, but if it happens, mm-hmm. then you're out.
Then I'm shaking it. Yeah. So you don't want to do that.
So what would you do in real life?
Keep me around. Let me stay around for a little bit.
So don't get attached because you want to stay around.
She said I love you and she wants to stay around. You don't love her.
She didn't get a chance to say it to me.
So what about I'm gone already. You already out. You
I'm already gone.
How would you feel?
Well, for me, if I like the girl, it's okay for her to be attached. Y'all do. I mean, they're all girls. Is that like, okay. Y'all ever have a situation where y'all like somebody? And
absolutely. But that's the communication there is a little different.
No, there's no.
No? You don't communicate with somebody you like if versus somebody that maybe shouldn't be liking you?
Here's why it's not different because...
Fucking with you versus liking you is different.
No, I'm going to tell you why it's not different. Because either way, whether I like them, they like me, regardless, if I'm not currently actively seeking a relationship, mm-hmm. then they probably should be getting attached to me whether I like them or not.
Correct.
For
that's
me.
That's how I feel.
That's fair.
So, but y'all saying... Y'all on the run regardless. I'm saying about.
No, I'm talking about.
Well, you said you gonna stick around. You said you sticking around. Regardless.
Yeah, I'm sticking around, but hey, don't love me.
But I'm saying, so how do y'all react if y'all like the girl?
If okay. I like her, that's a different story.
That's what he said too. Yeah, so how different is it?
I still don't want to wife you, but still stick around. Well, now I might express my emotion a little bit more.
It depends on how how she tried to play it. You making me work.
No,
you
know, she's saying she
y'all cares both care for each other.
I'm not. Y'all both don't even gotta care, but yes. She cares for you. She's attached to you. You're the person that she wants to be with, and she
and I want to be with her.
And you know, you just like her.
Oh, you just like her.
Wait. Yeah, maybe y'all get my words, Mr. Shu. So for me, I'll say how it is for me. There's girls that I might like, and mm-hmm. I don't gotta want to be with them and all that other stuff. I just like this person. I like them.
Fuck with her vibe. Yeah, and
I don't got to want more than just liking them.
Yeah, absolutely.
So I ain't saying you want to be with her. I ain't saying nothing. I'm saying this is somebody that you like.
Okay.
But she wants to be with
you. She's
me.
Attached to you, though. And she's expressing that she's attached.
Great friend.
Sweetheart, you don't... I this isn't that. I'm not...
No,
I'm
we're
not,
great friends.
I like you. I like you, but we're not
if
we're
I care
great
for
friends.
You,
absolutely.
No, yeah.
But I don't want to mess up our friendship just because you feel a type of way. Because I'm, obviously we're having sex. You know what I'm saying? So, because we're doing this, I don't want you to just start switching up and now it has to go somewhere.
How y'all think she would react to that?
Well.
Can you be mad at the truth? You can be mad, but what can you really do?
A lot of
truth?
Women hate the truth.
Right, so how do y'all think a woman's going to react to saying, she tells you that she's attached, y'all telling her that, oh, no, it's cool, we just friends, don't worry about it. Don't worry about it, but we still don't, I don't want to mess up our friendship.
No, I'm a friend that attached to you as well. I care for you.
So yes, you're going to tell her that she's saying she's attached to you, she really likes you.
I care for you too.
And, Trey, I care for you.
I care for you too, but we
got. I generally got feelings for you, like you got feelings for me. You my friend, I'll do whatever for you. I got your back.
So then she gonna say, well then why don't we just? I mean, since you got feelings for me, I got feelings for you. Why don't we just get in a relationship?
She's got a point.
Why would I get in a relationship?
Because we have feelings for each other.
I'm not ready yet.
So why are we doing this? Why are we building these feelings for each other if you're not ready for a relationship?
I care for you. Don't care too much for me. I'm telling you what it is. I'm not ready at this moment. But I care about
But it's
you.
Too late. My feelings are already built.
I told you not to do that shit.
But you got feelings too. Like, what's the issue?
My friend. I'm care for my friend. Like, you my cousins. I care for y'all.
Trey, I'm tired of this shit. They just zooming out.
You lost.
They probably come back around and say they got feelings.
Bro. Yeah, exactly.
Well, I would have handled it differently.
Yeah.
You can't account for the noise coming back.
What
they
did
do,
you say? They're going to come back around.
Yeah, they're probably coming back.
So, why I got to change my ways? I'm a man trying to strive and shit. Uh-huh. Why the fuck I got to change my ways? And you look for a relationship and the nigga who ain't shit, then come back to the nigga who might be something.
Well, if she's looking for it with you, what does that make you, though? Cause you're not looking for it, and you're not really embracing her feelings.
She's gonna leave me, find niggas playing shit, and come back to me.
But I'm saying, what does that make
that's,
you?
That's making you the same. You're now her rebound.
Okay.
I'm saying. So what?
I don't want to be with you then. I'm gonna fuck with
why
you.
Why? What are you?
I ain't gonna be.
Go
with
ahead.
You. Yeah. What you got?
Ask me the question formally. You know what I'm saying?
So I
forget.
She approaches you. That. Well, you know, I'm attached to you. I have these feelings for you. And this is something that you like her. Mm-hmm. How do you react when
great.
She says
you know,
that?
Here's the thing. This is great. I really appreciate you keeping it real with me, keeping it honest. I really don't want us to take it to that level at this point. And the reason why is because I value our friendship on that level.
But y'all having sex.
I value your friendship. I feel as if we got true feelings intertwined with this. You would start to think and look at me a different way. And I don't want to view you a different way, and I don't want you to view me a different way. You know what I'm saying? We are perfect right where we are. Have you been mad? Typically, they'll say no, right? Have you had a problem? Have you been upset with anything? We go get some food here and there. We go. You might get me something for my birthday. I might get you something for your birthday. You know what I'm saying? But we're perfect right here.
On some chill shit.
So to put a label on it literally would be doing what? What would that do for her? Is what I would ask. That would be my following question.
And she'd probably be like, well, we're already doing most of these things.
And
why not?
What's up. That's,
why not
that's
continue
lit.
To build in that direction?
Because what are we doing it for? I don't, do you, are you, because what, I mean, again, this would be hypothetical. This is what I would ask her. Do you see yourself marrying me?
No.
At this age, I'm 26.
Well,
she'd be kind of getting on. You know what I'm saying?
No. She would probably be like, well, I don't know because we haven't taken the steps and we haven't been in a relationship.
So what's wrong with our friendship right now?
Well, she would say that. We need to progress our friendship to the next stages because we've already.
It sounds like she hasn't answered my question. What is wrong with what we're doing?
It's stagnant.
It's stagnant? What makes you think it's stagnant?
Because we're not progressing.
I'm mentally growing your train of thought.
I'm figuring out what I like in women. You're not learning with me? And I put it on. It's now balls in her court. I mean.
Right, yeah. No, she would definitely be like that stagnant. Yeah. Oh, she should be. I don't know. Girls probably won't say that.
I'm learning from her. You're teaching me plenty.
What would you do?
So I can't imagine that she's not learning at this point.
Right.
She likes him, what she doesn't like.
Is she like, nigga, I love you. And you ain't ready for all that. What would you do?
So she's saying she loves me or she's attached to me. That's two different things.
That borderline saying shit.
It's completely different.
All right, but she likes you.
She's expressing her feelings for me. And this is somebody that I like.
Yeah.
I'm simply just going to keep it a bug. I'm like, that's not where I'm at in life. I'm growing towards that. I'm continuously trying to be better, trying to figure that out, trying to figure out if that's the route that I want to go. I don't know if I want to go that route yet. Simple as that. I'm still figuring out if I want to go that route or not. I don't know.
So the I don't know is what was key.
Well, I'm keep it a bean though.
We all said the same shit.
No, we all said the same
different way.
But he said, I don't know.
Because you don't know.
Me and Trey are turning it down where.
I'm not ready.
In fairness, he's saying you're not ready, and I'm saying I ain't even on it.
Spin the block around, come back.
So, you're saying,
I'm unsure because this is somebody that I like, so I might want to go that route. I like this person. I don't want to, I want this person to stay around. So I want to keep that door open.
Well, you always tell him I'm not going to rule it out. But I'm not going to necessarily tell
I'm not going to I'm
going to tell you I won't rule it out.
I'm going to push it more towards the positive and say I don't know yet.
But you say I don't know, like no, you the only nigga I want to fuck with. You do this shit now or not at all.
And I was going to say I was going to keep it a buck. This girls that gave me the ultimatum where they're like, well, if you can't be on that same page as me, then I gotta exit.
Okay, wait, here's a great question for that. What if you was just about to cut her ass off anyways?
That's easier.
You know what I'm saying? But I've been on both sides. Prior to that question though, you know what I'm saying? She's just coming to you like, then I was. She's coming to you before she gives you that ultimatum. She's coming to you like, yo, I really like you like that, and you're like, wow, I was just, you don't even know, I was about to kick you to the curb. Like I was getting bored with what we were doing. Not the scenario, because I'm finna go maybe find somebody else to do it with. Hypothetically speaking.
Okay. So
if I was about to cut her off, done with you at this time.
If I was about to cut her off, then I mean I would just be like, oh, okay, damn, that's too bad.
Yeah, but
I ain't with that. I'm not going that route right now.
But you weren't about to cut her off because you genuinely like her.
You just gonna cut her. You gonna cut throat like that because you feel for this person.
You just said I was about to cut her off.
You're gonna cut her off as far as, you know, you can cut a female or a woman off sexually and kind of really just keep it on some friendship.
Yes, I'm gonna tell her like this. That's not the route I'm going right now.
Dang, you just cut throat like that.
Yeah, I've 100% been in a situation where it's been somebody where I was about to cut off, and it's been people where it's been like, if they can stick around, no question, I'll wipe them up. But I just need some more time. Mm-hmm. It's been.
Oh, but they got to do it.
They gave me that ultimatum. Like, you're either gonna do this or I'm a dip.
Yeah, see.
And there's been some high quality joints like that. It was like, damn, I let that one slide. Or I'm salty afterward.
That's tough because it's a good point to put the pressure on the dude, but it depends on when. But it also depends on like what
you put pressure on a nigga, that ain't gonna be the ideal nigga because he ain't want to do that shit in the first place.
If you have to put pressure on that nigga, that's not true. That's not true. Because a female has to put pressure on me, and she can fool herself.
I don't agree. I think if you're a girl, if you're a girl, you have high confidence in yourself, and you think you're a high quality woman, and you're talking to a nigga and having sex with him,
you're trying to get nigga, in your bag. What's up? You're trying to get in your bag. I can respect. Matter of fact, I might respect that a little bit more.
Yeah, I respect it 10 times. I'm like, nigga, what's up? What you trying to do? I mean, I'm not gonna sit here and keep waiting on you. You know what I'm saying? Be confident like that. It was like, I don't need you, nigga. Mm. If you want to like. I like that type of confidence. Where like, no, approach me like that. If I ain't ready, then shit. So Trey, and talk to me like
that.
Yeah,
you know what I'm saying.
Trey let him punch on him, but he just won't.
Yeah, they got to knock Trey out. They got to get in line.
Hypotheticals. That's just straight hypotheticals.
So I like a confident woman like that where they're like, well, these is your options. What are you going to do? Like, react.
Yeah, I'm with it. I'm sold.
So I don't want a chick to be like just waiting. No, have some confidence. Like, I don't need this thing. Even though I think highly of myself, I think I'm, you know, great. But shit,
pull that shit. Now I just know where
yeah, so you can say the shit, but niggas ain't ready because not black men. But I seen men out here who girl gave that ultimatum, and like that's still the only woman they fuck with.
But
so if I'm ready, I'm gonna be 100% ready.
But by doing that, like I just said, there's chances you could miss out on high quality women by not being ready.
That's the. Are you
that's what I'm saying.
Willing to take that risk.
That is that the risk you're willing to take. That's what I'm saying exactly.
What? So you've been through it.
I've been through it more than once. I done lost some high quality joints.
Worth it.
No.
Oh no, it's never worth it.
No,
it ain't never worth it.
It ain't never worth it.
Yeah, it's some stress. I could be chilling right now. I could be living the life. Yeah, I don't let high quality joints go.
Okay, can I put one out there? Can I put a hypothetical out there?
Yeah, get a hypothetical on the menu.
Just a hypothetical, like this never happened, but this is just a hypothetical. My guy, right, one of my friends, hypothetically, had this girl, right, cool, damn near cuffed her, right, but didn't really like. They had like we're saying, like no label, but like it's that. You know what I'm saying? Y'all both know. You know what I'm saying? But shorty's got like. 5 kids, right?
Mm-hmm.
But she's got, you know, hypothetically speaking, let him tell it. She's thick as hell, you know what I'm saying? Got boxed from heaven. You know
what does she do for a living?
She's like a nurse, you know what I'm saying? So, like, that's a
something
medical field. You know, I don't know if it's a nurse, hypothetically speaking, but it's something in the medical field. Okay. You know what I'm saying? So, it's a pretty decent bag. He's not trying to cuff her. Because this guy doesn't necessarily want to be dealing with the kids. But now he cut her off because he didn't want to have to worry about that, right?
Mm-hmm.
But now he says he misses her. Okay. She's not fucking with him.
Okay.
It'd be like that.
What's he to do? I be trying to tell him, like, bro. He say, bro, I think I'm ready. He's not
really. Nah, she ain't got time for him.
And she stopped fucking with me. She got two kids. Like,
No.
He said five. He said,
oh, five. Yeah. Kind of kids.
She ain't got time for his shit.
Yeah, she's like,
do you think she's butthurt at all?
No.
Because they had a good situation, but
she
now
got
she's
feeling, but
she's not fucking with him now because
she a woman.
He cut
another
it off.
Nigga gonna fuck with her.
Cause she just don't got time. She don't got time to put like this. Simple as that. She doesn't have time to be dealing with a nigga that don't know what he want. Simple as that.
Yeah. Okay.
Simple as that.
She had the time before, but now she
doesn't. Since you don't know, nigga, it's cool.
Potential.
Yeah. So she basically like, I got other shit to do. Like, since you don't know, I'm cool on you.
Facts. Okay.
I've been told that before, so that's all.
I mean, yeah. Yeah.
That happens, you know. Hey, whatever.
I'll have to let him know.
So it's just something. I mean, I would say if I was gonna give this young man advice, I would say, wait a year and a half, wait 2 years, come back in the picture, 2 years from now.
Wait your shit together.
I mean,
she gonna like that shit.
But here's the thing though. What's the when you hypothetically speaking, you're still not trying to cuff her. You really just want to hit again.
Oh, man.
So like, but she's not. You
play
know, she's not.
Right.
It's still just wait a year too.
Play
give
her
some
right.
time. Give her some time. Like a year go by quick. I mean, you know, you wait a year, hit a joint back up. They'll forget some shit.
Quick.
Then be like, damn, what happened? I don't know how old these people are, but like, damn, what? Why we stop? What happened? Yeah. Why we stop?
This was another thing I want to talk about with you guys. So you feel me? You get a girl number snap right away. It takes her 3 months to 3.5 years to hit you back and start fucking with you. How will you treat that situation before? Like, is she fucking with you first quarter to the way she fucking with you now?
Depends for me. Depends on the quality. How high quality is she as a woman? That's 100% determines how I'm treating her.
Oh, if she's ugly or not, how do you?
No, it's like quality for me. It looks.
It's all of that. It's all of that.
That's like light. Like you know what I'm saying? Like if I'm even approaching you, probably look decent. Like I ain't even. How high of a quality are you? Somebody that's almost pretty much basically unattainable by the general public and the general niggas.
So if you are worth it, then not.
Yeah, so I mean, based off of who you are and how you really moving around within the city, that's going to determine how I'm going to treat you. If you just outside and you just flexing on me, then I'm going to flex on you. If you just a high quality young lady where it's just like, it ain't many niggas going to be able to talk to her, like, period.
So the fact
you give me the time of day.
I'm going to have to handle this right.
Yeah, like I'm gonna treat them two completely different.
So then, absolutely, yeah, I'm gonna take my time with it and definitely handle it with patience. But right. if I have a gut feeling or I'm getting signs that you're out there giving up the poom poom, and you just playing me like I'm supposed to be like the savior, I'm gonna have to let the streets pay your tab. I gotta let you go.
To the streets, my G.
That ain't for me.
To the streets.
That ain't for me.
But let's
say. Might be for somebody, though.
Is that. So, let's go romantic. We're gonna turn that into a romantic or red flag. So, come across. Let's say she's a bottle server. Come across a bottle server. Get her information. She doesn't respond to you till 2-3 years later. But she responds gung-ho all for you. Romantic or red flag. She's finding them up. Super fine. Romantic or red flag.
We outside. What's the red flag?
I'm going red flag.
I'm gonna fuck with you, yes, but don't expect me more than to fuck with you.
Why you think romantic?
Romantic, you can come through. It's all about how I handle it, right? Mm-hmm. Afterwards, yeah. I'm gonna go as romantic as now I want to because now once I get into romantic, let's say, you know, you share yourself with me, right? Let's say you share yourself with me, right?
Yeah,
and now, you know. Maybe I can say, you took too long to really kind of fuck with me, and I'm just going to keep you at a distance. I fuck with you, but it's never going to get to anything past what
that's
I
want to
do.
That's why I'm going to do that. That's why it's a red flag, cause regardless, I'm going to find a way to fuck with you. It just ain't going to be, we're together type shit.
Yeah, I'm kind of with Trey on that one.
Yeah, like, I'm going to fuck with you, because that's what I want to do.
Dang, so that falls under the red flag?
Yeah.
For us.
Yeah, I'm going to fuck with you regardless. So, I'm
still
gonna. If I do it with heart, that means I would have wiped you. No, I'm not gonna fuck.
Oh, see, when I think red flag, I'm not even giving her the time of day.
Oh no,
I'm not giving her that much time like that. Like either she's coming through and going, or I'm cool.
Absolutely, but when I think red flag, I'm not answering the phone.
I'm gonna give you some time, but it's gonna be on my standards, on my basis of the ground, it's on my playing field.
Yeah, I ain't even gonna give you that much time. It's really like you got maybe one or two chances to hang out, and it's either
I definitely
thing
got the
or
hard field advantage
I'm cool.
On this one.
Like, it's gotta be quick, or I'm just good. Like, I'm cool. Don't even worry about it. So yeah. Next one, romantic red flag. It's a girl that you want to deal with, and she has no friends. She's completely a loner.
Red flag. Major red flag.
Why a major red flag, though?
Major red flag. You finna try and be around me all day. I'm flipping such out that way. Now, you gonna try and be around me all day. And I like that. I can enjoy that, but then you gonna... Nah. Because then you start doing some crazy shit.
Yeah, clearly she crazy. Every girl be like, I ain't got no friends just for a reason. So don't... Ain't no bitch fucking with you.
And why don't you have friends?
Maybe she doesn't have friends because...
Every friend ain't dirty.
No, maybe just because she's busy.
But you have a boyfriend?
No, y'all just talking, my G.
I'm saying, you trying to have a boyfriend, but you don't got friends?
Yeah, they just alone. They enjoy being alone. They don't really want to kick it with nobody. They don't go out. They don't hang out.
If she close to a family member, at least they could be friends.
Yeah, like something. You can't be
but alone. But if you ain't talking with nobody, then it's on you. That's
she a red flag. She goes to work and she goes home. That's to read a book.
That's a red flag. If you're in your bag, I might help get you out your bag.
There's circumstances. She's not a perfect person.
That's not being perfect. I'm just saying, she just goes home after work. Like,
she's like, chilling.
She'd be like, I don't like going out. I don't like doing none of that stuff. I just like to sit at home and be and watch my Netflix and watch my shows.
She got friends,
and read
though.
A book.
No, she
like, you ain't got hang
what's
out with
wrong
your,
with that?
She can have friends, but it's not like you got to hang out with your friend. Don't say, Jacob, I can't hang out with my friends. Ain't your friend.
No, she said, I don't have no
friends.
She
friend. Doesn't have like, anybody that she can go on. She has no group chat.
I don't have no group chat. She don't talk to nobody.
Does anything.
I don't trust you.
So, listen, y'all. So let me ask y'all. Let me flip it. So let me ask y'all this. So romantic or red flag then? Romantic or red flag? Having a chick this side every weekend. You're talking to your girl this side every weekend.
How deep am I trying to?
Nigga, out every weekend. You just
you trying to
chop it up flag. Like.
Red that's flag. If I'm not trying to wife her.
So wait a minute.
If I'm trying to wipe
y'all out. Niggas all over the place.
No. I'm looking at this.
It's just how I kick with her. That's romantic. Do you?
Yeah,
nah,
I
ain't gonna
like
control your life.
The standard is a little different, but
Man, you red flag and everything.
No, here's the thing. If I'm just fucking with you, I actually need you out every weekend because I be chilling at home on Saturdays.
So you a home nigga.
So slide on me when you're done going out. You're lit. You have fun with your friends. You did what you did. Come home to Papa.
Come
chill.
Home to me.
We can do whatever we got to do. You know what I'm saying?
Too funny.
But as far as if I'm trying to cuff you, I don't need you out every week. I'll let you have your weekends. You know what I'm saying?
You let her have her weekends.
Go ahead. Go
so, you sound like a pet.
So
Nah, I don't mean it like that, but just like, you know, because I might be trying to do something on the weekend. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
Like, and I can't be like, okay, well, I set this up for Saturday night. Because definitely I need my weekends for me and the guys. You know what I'm saying? Uh-huh. Me and the bros is kicking it. Typically when this Rona shit not around, we got like Saturday night basketball games and shit like that.
But anyways.
Nah, hold on. So one more. So what about romantic red flag? Talking to a chick that's super shy or timid.
I like it. I'm with it.
Damn, that's tough.
You should be confident in what there's something you should.
I'm
not mad at it.
Yeah, I'm not a fan.
Are you
in my cup of tea?
Are you able to get her out her shell?
I ain't got time to do all that. I'm 30 years old, my G. I ain't trying to bring anybody out their shell.
Damn.
Like I don't got time for that. I don't have time to break you out of your shell. Like I'm a lovely, fine, you know, friendly person. If you just shy, then that's just you. It's cool. Don't worry about it. Talk to them. I ain't finna try too much. Like, nah, I ain't doing that either. You feel me or not? Like,
yeah, but there's. If you know she's feeling it, but that's the thing about
timid
women is like
timid.
I never really
they,
never really
which is, it could this. Be foul like they want to represent the best selves like first quarter
or they just might not be that sociable as people. They just could be shy and they're just not that comfortable with talking to people. Might not be the thing they want
to
put on the best.
Well,
themselves.
That's hard for me to even really kind of vibe with you because.
It's hard.
I'm trying to like if we can't converse or have
that's what I'm saying. You got to force it out of them. Force conversation.
And sometimes it's a difference. It's like.
Yeah,
converse is a word.
Yeah, like you messing with a stripper or some shit. She don't want to. Oh, I won't strip in front of you. I'll fuck with you. I'll let you be my boyfriend, but I won't strip.
What the fuck is that? They be telling you?
Well, that's different though.
That's the same shit.
No, because stripping is their job.
Yeah, but
so if they're saying I'm not going to strip in front of you,
they're kind
of
shocked and they don't.
No.
In front of dude, they
that's
like,
not the same thing.
No, I'm rolling with Trey. Why can't you strip in front of
because,
me?
Because nigga, is you finna pay?
Hey, I ain't gotta pay.
So if I get paid to strip,
but no, you on that stage, I fuck with you. I didn't happen to go to the strip.
No, that's not the same.
And you feel some type of way you strip in front of me. You on stage.
But nigga, I get paid to be on stage. So what's up? It's like simple as that. I get paid to be on stage.
Every nigga strip club ain't paying. They just
but either way, I get it's advertising you to pay me whenever I come down to this floor now.
Okay.
So you don't if you're have not to pay. If you're not, but I'm saying so they when they go on stage, it's advertising for when they come down to the floor. Mm-hmm. So now it's easy to chop up whoever and possibly they'll buy some dances or whatever. Mm-hmm. If you're not gonna pay me, why am I just stripping for you just cause?
But she would do regardless. No, she would do regardless. But now you just the simple fact, oh, she know you didn't talk to you now.
Yeah, I'm telling you why. It's because you. That's my job.
Yeah, she's saying she's not gonna take it to a
so why am I doing?
Level.
Why am I bringing this home to my personal stuff? That's my job. You want me to strip, then pay me, and I'll strip. What's up?
What happened? You just walk in and shit, and you ain't know she was a stripper.
That's did you walk in at work? If it's just like
this is your girl, right?
No, they just talking.
He trying to make you your girl?
The girl.
He just somebody he talked to. Like, just somebody like, she just entertaining. Yeah. You just entertaining.
This ain't even like, she. This
y'all
is
not even that deep.
This is your girl and she became a stripper. She probably gonna strip for you. But if you.
This is somebody
if you
probably
pull up on her when she's a stripper, she's not.
It's probably somebody you haven't had sex with them clearly yet.
Oh, yeah, she's not stripper.
Even if you have sex with them, they still might not feel comfortable stripping at her job in front of you.
I have to ask her what she's in it for. What's
that's
your
really a real thing.
It's called not mixing business and pleasure. It's as simple as that. It's a simple concept. Very simple, and that's how most businesses should be ran. You shouldn't mix the two. It's not good business. That's like business fundamentals. You don't mix the two. So if she says, no, I don't want you coming to my job, nigga, that's... Oh, I don't want no bitch coming to my job! You want somebody coming to your job?
Just watching me? Nah.
It's weird. It's weird then.
And you're in the entertainment business, right. That should be different. You know what what comes with it.
No, because you can set boundaries and say, I don't want my person coming to this spot. This person, and if you are that person that wants to keep coming, then you're not the person for me. It's
but then it might be like, that might be a specific entertainment.
If you fuck with them, you should know where they work.
But if you're an athlete, if you're a pro athlete, do you not? I mean, that same rule doesn't necessarily apply. You know what I'm saying?
Mixing business and pleasure?
If having your whomever pull up to what you're doing as your business. LeBron always got Savannah at the game.
Right.
If he can. You know what I'm saying? I would feel that's the same thing. But he can hoop at the crib with her. You know what I'm saying?
The
like
difference
can,
would be,
he can play 2-1 or horse with his girl.
I'll tell you, so Savannah's not at practice. Savannah's not, can't interact within the game. If somebody comes to see you at your job, where you can, they could possibly interact you, they could possibly distract you.
Fans can definitely interact and distract.
So, but I'm saying, so in an arena where it's the athlete,
LeBron's wife,
it's 20,000 people.
Of course, all right.
How much interaction is she really gonna get? She can't walk on the court and good job, baby.
Do you remember? Well, how about this? Let's look at it like maybe it's a different perspective. Do you remember when Chris Bosh's wife was on that with LeBron, and LeBron went for 40?
From the stands.
So now this is Chris Bosh's wife, right? He's got his wife.
But this,
here,
but I'm saying
now she's fucking up his business.
No, but she's not directly interacting with them. So if somebody comes to your job, they can walk straight up to you. Mm-hmm. If somebody goes to a stripper job, you can walk straight up to them. You can't mm-hmm. walk straight up to LeBron while he's shooting a free throw.
I'm just saying, if I was a dude and my girl went to a strip club, I would interact with her in the first place. That's your business. But don't be shy. I'm gonna let you do you, but don't be shy about it.
I don't think it's about being shy. I really think it's about mixing business.
She's saying she don't
pleasure.
Want you there at all.
Yeah, because like I said, this business. She's
weird.
At work. She's putting on her
that.
Work face, and she's about to go hustle. She don't want you watching her hustle.
And we did cool. Like I told you, first quarter. I ain't
it
on
still
that.
Will make somebody feel awkward because it's like this is somebody that I like cool. In real life. Now they're watching me pretend to like these other people. It makes people uncomfortable, which makes sense. I don't want to see you put you watching me go finesse these dudes that I don't like. I like you for real in real life. So I don't want you watching me because I don't want you watching me as I try to finesse everybody in the room. Yeah. I don't want that.
I don't judge. Would y'all date a stripper?
We already did a podcast. Right?
Oh, okay.
This has been the Wholesome Podcast. Hey, look, we three wholesome black men, and we all know that black men don't cheat.
Absolutely. At the end of the day.
Oh, yeah. Absolutely.
Yeah, you know. We appreciate Marky Mark coming through.
I had to pull up.
Wavy Trey with no waves in the building.